Growing up in secondary school, I started to experience more physical symptoms on top of the lightheadedness as well. I had chest pains, very frequent headaches, nosebleeds. Being in an all-boys school, there's a kind of expectation to at least, you know, go for some physical activities. I was regularly the last to be picked for, like, say, basketball games, that kind of thing. After a while, it kind of got to a point where it's kind of part of my life, it's me, so just roll with it, just deal with it, yeah. In school, teachers would ask you about your future thoughts, your aspirations, your plans. I realized that I didn't actually have any aspirations, didn't have any drive to think forward. In 2007, this girl brought me to New Creation Church for the first time.
Actually, when we first dated, we didn't know. His stamina is not on par with people of his age. And I noticed he had too frequent, like, nose bleeding, and like his headaches were really intense.
As we progressed in our relationship, I began to feel that I was holding Janet back a bit because of my physical condition, not being able to do the things that she is used to doing, lots of sports every week. Exercise regime had to be cut back. We even had to plan our dates to make sure there's not nothing too strenuous.
Later, when we found out because of his national service and he went for army check, and then
the condition I had actually was mitral valve prolapse, which is a heart condition that has to do with the valves not being formed properly, possibly from birth. One of the valves is basically not working properly, where it's quite flaccid. When it moves, opens and closes, it's like a it's a bit more whip-like motion instead of what it's supposed to be, which is more taut, like a door opening or closing. More serious cases, it can even in the future lead to sudden death or cardiac arrest.
My parents were really concerned when they realised that he's younger and he's weaker, and I had to make a decision whether I would want to continue and believe for healing or just bye-bye.
I didn't really feel like I had healing coming my way yet, because I was dealing with this my whole life. If it comes, great, but if it doesn't, you know, I still had that, like, kind of, I'm already living with it, so it's okay lah, you know. In 2010, I was in the car on the way to pick Jenna to choir practice for Resurrection Sunday. I actually started experiencing chest pains while driving. This is not really something that you want to experience. I just pulled to the side of the road. I guess at that point, I decided that I don't want to live with this anymore. I was in the car, just putting the Resurrection Sundays practice songs on loop, and one of the songs is called This Blood. I just sang them and allowed it to minister to me. As I was singing the songs, the lyrics, you know, this blood can save your soul, heal the sick, mend your heart. I felt a warm, trickling sensation down my back. The pain just gently went away. I guess I was quite skeptical at the time. I didn't think that it was a healing, but okay, it's just kind of gone. And okay, then so I just drove off and went to meet Jenna.
We went to verify it with a doctor, and we did the proper scans. And
the difference is visible between the before and after shots of the scan of my heart. To be able to see this difference physically in front of your own eyes, it's like a kind of confirmation of the healing, especially when the doctor that we saw before said that it's an incurable condition. Personally, looking at my stamina, the symptoms that are now gone, there is no doubt that healing's taken place.
I really feel very blessed, you know, to be part of the healing process and to see the before and the after. To me, it's really a wonderful experience.
I guess God was also preparing us for our daughter to come, you know, because if I was in the physical state that I was in before I got healed, no way would I be able to look after a child, you know. Sometimes the whole day on Sunday, you know, after serving, I'll be looking after her, and this kind of thing really can only happen because of, by the grace of God. The stamina that I have, that I need to even look after Melody for the whole day, is only there by the grace of God.
And also, like, we can go for longer outdoor activities so that we can engage the little one. Like, we can go to Marina Bay Sands, Flower Dome, walk the whole day, and then after that, go somewhere else instead of having to rush home straight away to sleep. Yeah, so
it's a lot more fun now. Serving has also impacted my life a lot. It's in the choir where I've matured and grown as a person that my healing experience happened while practicing for choir practice, but also doing life with my choir mates, fellow servers, my leaders, just having the sharing sessions. It's really impacted me as a person. I've also have a purpose in life, that's something I can look forward to and work towards rather than just languishing, you know, in my weakness. God is my support, because looking back now, I can honestly say that He's always been with me through. He's just really constantly lifting me up. And when I'm down, He's there.
Hallelujah, 弟兄姐妹，你看到吗？这位很年轻的弟兄，他在他的这个学生时期的时候，就一直觉得，为什么我总是那么的会容易的头疼，为什么总是会流鼻血的？后来才发觉到，原来他有先天性的心脏发育不全的一个问题，所以以至于他常常很容易的疲累。弟兄姐妹，他不能够像我们作息一样，可能他不久之后活动不久之后，他就觉得不行了，我需要休息。可是你看到他的转变在哪个时候？当他驾车那个当儿，当他的心脏突然间感到疼痛的时候，他对主说，主，我不要再有这个现象了，我不要再有这个现象了，我要领受你的医治。弟兄姐妹，上帝不要我们等待我们的奇迹，上帝不要我们拖延我们的祝福，不要告诉自己说没关系啦，这个现象在我的身上已经习惯了。不，在这个新的一年，我要你期待上帝这个时候就要医治你，上帝在这个时候就要祝福你。当这个弟兄他的心思意念一转，他说我不要这个疼痛了，我要领受上帝的医治的时候，当他来到上帝的面前，当他开始播这首歌的时候，主的宝血就提醒了他，主的宝血洗净他一切的罪，主的宝血可以带给他医治，给他脱离一切的病痛的时候，就在那一刹那，他得到了痊愈。哈利路亚，弟兄姐妹，当他再去做报告的时候，医生都不得不惊讶他的 X 光的这个照片，为什么是全然不一样了？在医生的眼中，觉得是不可能的，是不可能治愈的。但是弟兄姐妹，我们是属于耶稣的，上帝要你期待美好的祝福，上帝不要你再单言你的祝福，不要再单言你的健康，不要再单言你的医治，好不好？这个时候你举起你的手，跟我一起做这个宣告的祷告。耶稣，我相信我得医治，我拒绝一切的病痛，我拒绝一切的癌细胞，我拒绝一切的老化的现象，我知道我拥有耶稣的健康，我领受，阿们。弟兄姐妹，还是你遇到工作上的挑战，你不晓得你应该换一个工作，还是你面临现在失业的情况，我要你举起手来跟耶稣说，耶稣，我相信你已经为我开了一道好的门，你要赐给我好的工作，不但是好的工作，还有好的薪金，还有一个好的职位，因为你要我成为别人的祝福，我相信这一道好的门你亲自为我而开，我领受，阿们。弟兄姐妹，真的，上帝要我们来到他的面前，大胆的享受，大胆的来领受，他是祝福于我们的神。这个时候我要你们看最后一个经文，这是在路加福音的第五章第三到第四节。有一只船是西门的，耶稣就上去请他把船撑开，稍微离岸就坐下，从船上教训众人，讲完了对西门说，把船开到水深之处，下网打鱼。 为什么我会提出这个经文呢？你看到吗？当彼得在领受祝福之前，耶稣做了什么？耶稣借用了他的船在教训众人，也就是说什么？耶稣在教导神的话语，耶稣在分享天国的福音。当他说完了之后，他转向彼得，对彼得说，也就是说彼得就在场听耶稣所讲的话。今年你要期待好的祝福吗？今年你是否要持续的看到上帝美好的祝福在地如在天，美好的祝福临到你呢？弟兄姐妹，让我们继续的聆听神的福音，让我们继续聆听神的话语。真的不但是听过，还是听进，把它放在你的心中，让上帝的话语来带领你。不是新闻的消息，不是报章的消息，而是上帝的话语来充满你。弟兄姐妹，一起的祷告，祷告上帝赐给我们启示和智慧的灵来充满着我们，打开我们，照明我们心中的眼睛。弟兄姐妹，让我们真的知道他。哈利路亚，我相信主在今年里面要让你期待前所未有的祝福。哈利路亚，弟兄姐妹，满载的祝福，真的是超乎你所求所想的祝福都要临到你。祝福你们新年蒙大恩蒙大福。哈利路亚。好，这个时候我要带领在电视机前的你，可能今天是你第一次聆听神的福音，今天可能是你的亲戚朋友把这个连接发给你，告诉你一起的来领受这个好的消息。真的是在这个世上我们没有办法听到好的消息，但是上帝告诉你说这个福音就是他的好消息。我真的相信说上帝要带领你领受美好的祝福，他要来到你生命中，给你前所未有想象美好的祝福，好不好？这个时候如果你要接受耶稣成为你生命的救主，让我来带领你，你跟着我一起的来祷告，打开你的心，打开你的手，一起的来宣告。耶稣，我领受你的祝福，我知道你为了我死在十字架上，就是要将我一切的罪拿走，将你公义的身份给了我，让我领受你美好的祝福。我相信我领受，今天我回到神的家中了，我相信上帝你的祝福是临到我的，我要领受你福杯满溢的生命。感谢你耶稣，阿们。今天如果你做了这个节制的祷告，你可以以下的方式与我们联络，我们有好的一个资料资源要放在你的手中，要带领你领受，要带领你认识你在耶稣基督里面的身份和祝福。感谢主，哈利路亚，恭喜你弟兄姐妹。好，这个时候好不好让我来祝福你们，好不好？我们一起的来打开我们的手，来接受这个美好的祝福。耶稣，谢谢你让我们在春节的时刻领受你美好的祝福，看到上帝你天打开了，倾倒你的祝福在我们的生命当中，我们是蒙大恩蒙大福的。这个春暖花开庆新年的祝福，这个宴享美福得平安的祝福都要领到我们。耶稣，我们谢谢你让我们满蒙主恩，让我们的生命福杯满溢。感谢你耶稣，奉耶稣基督的名祷告，阿们。弟兄姐妹们，祝福你们蒙大恩蒙大福。